All right, so James and I just got back from seeing the new Mighty Morphin Power Rangers movie.
Or just Power Rangers this time.
Oh, is it just called Power Rangers?
Well, it's like Ninja Turtles, like, you know, that people don't say Teenage Mutant Ninja anymore. Like, the recent movies, I think it was just Ninja Turtles.
Well, this is based off Mighty Morphin Power Rangers, not any of the others, right? So it's... I actually don't know. Is it called Mighty Morphin Power Rangers or is it just called Power Rangers?
The title, I'm pretty sure. I think it's Saban's Power Rangers.
That's Well, it'd be good if we can start by getting the title of the movie right.
How do you like that beginning?
Yeah. So, all right. We're going to have a lot of thoughts.
It was pretty good.
Okay.
Go ahead.
I also thought it was pretty good. Mm-hmm. So, if you want to know what we thought, we both liked it. I didn't think the movie was amazing, but I liked it. I don't like to give like ratings, but if I had to, maybe like a 7 out of 10 or something like that. Okay. I thought it was pretty good. I will say that I really liked that they gave the Rangers, the kids, time on screen and time for us to get to know each of the characters. Because in the movie, obviously, we know that they become the Power Rangers. Mm-hmm. But what I liked probably the most was... they go fairly early on to put on their outfits, and you're like, all right, here we go. They're going to become the Ranger. And then they can't transform into being Rangers. Mm-hmm. And they have to learn, you know, they have to learn to fight, and they have to learn all that and their abilities. But they have to actually learn who each other are and become friends. And actually, they have to learn to care about each other.
It sort of does what... the show does very quickly. Like, the show is very fast-paced, where it's actually interesting to see how you could tell the story without it being kind of, like, made into a 20-minute episode.
Sure.
Where, like, in the course of 20 minutes, there's already Megazord. They're already up to that
right.
in 20 minutes.
Well,
on
in the show, they have to get to it very quickly.
Yeah, the show is really just about, like, you know, it was made for kids, obviously. It was very much like any of the other shows where it's like all about fast entertainment.
Mm-hmm.
This is kind of like, this is Power Rangers, if you want to see it extended, done as, you know, giving time, like you're saying, all the characters and everything.
Yeah, and I really did like that they did that. I will say some of the reasons that I was originally fans of the show back in the 90s, I would say that there was two real reasons why. One, you know, I liked watching cheesy television shows like Full House and Saved by the Bell and all that. And Power Rangers, the original show, fit into that mold. You turn it on and it just seemed like any old, you know, Saved by the Bell type of show. But then obviously it went into having, you know, all the action and special effects and stuff. So I liked it for that because I liked cheesy television.
Mm-hmm.
And also, the other thing I liked about the original show was the monsters. Sometimes you would have like a turtle with a traffic light on its head, or you'd have like a pig with a Marvin the Martian helmet, and they had these ridiculous monster characters. Mm-hmm. And I think that those are two things that were lost in this movie, because they did a great job with these characters, but it wasn't cheesy. It didn't have that like Saved by the Bell type of feel to it. It was done much better, I guess, but in a way... I felt like that's missing because that's kind of... I like the cheesiness, I guess, is what I'm trying to say. And also, as far as the monsters go, one of the main things I loved about Power Rangers... In fact, probably the main thing I loved about Power Rangers was seeing all the goofy monsters. One of the episodes had the Frankenstein monster and, you know, just all those goofy... the pumpkin head guy and all that. And this movie, you know, it's largely CG special effects, even though there are practical effects in the movie, which is cool. Like, I think Zordon... in the beginning, when he's an alien and Rita and things like that, they actually do use some practical effects, which is nice to see. But largely it is CGI.
Like once you get to the Zords and you get to Goldar and everything.
So I think something is lost there. I hope that if they make a sequel to this movie, that they're not afraid to get a little cheesy with it. And this movie had cheesy moments, but. I don't want that to be lost in the future.
Yeah, that's a tough balance. That's a tough topic, actually, because I don't know.
I mean, do you agree? Like, is that one of the reasons you like the original show? Because I know you're a fan of, Gamera and those type of villains and how, like, cheesy sort of they were.
Yeah, yeah.
And do you know what I mean about the appeal of the cheesiness?
I mean, I feel like I said everything I've ever wanted to say about Power Rangers. I basically just crunched Power Rangers in the past like few months now because I did the movie reviews. I did a two-part movie review. I just did the nerd episode, which I just finished moments before.
Right.
We saw this
literally
movie.
it was filmed, finished today, right?
I'm on post AVGN mode, guys. I'm just like, I was just happy just to watch a movie, just to kind of sit down and enjoy it. So I watched it very casually.
Mm-hmm.
I enjoyed the movie. I'm just glad to hear somebody else talk about Power Rangers for once instead of...
instead of you having me thinking about it.
Yeah, it's like, oh my God, Power Rangers. But this is kind of like the finale to all that for me, because now I actually went into a new Power Rangers movie already knowing something about the show now, when really, you know, it's obviously it's a movie where you don't have to know anything about the show. It's really Power Rangers Origins. This is like the beginning,
yeah.
You know, and that's what most of these franchises are doing. It's, you know, reboot it, start it over for, because this is one where this is what they needed to do with Power Rangers, because there's so many Power Rangers shows and there's so many, there's just
they
so much to it.
Yeah.
There's just nothing else you could do. It was like, okay, well, let's do it over. And it seems like they're gearing it toward maybe a slightly older audience range,
yeah.
But not much older. It's,
yeah.
It's about the same. So I think like early teens, this movie is kind of geared for.
Mm-hmm.
And I think for that, for the market, for what this movie was trying to do, I think they got it just about right. You know, I don't see any...
Yeah, I think they got it
really.
Just about right. One of the things I really liked that they did was, you know, there's the famous line, make my monster grow.
Mm-hmm.
They actually gave a little bit of reason to
mm-hmm.
that. Before, in the show, it would just be any old monster, and then they would just grow, and Rita would throw down her staff
mm-hmm.
and all that. But in
yeah.
this, Rita actually goes around and collecting little gold pieces,
uh-huh.
and she actually assembles them, making the monster grow.
Yeah.
You know, so there was actually kind of a reason for that, which I thought was cool.
Yeah, and you think, and you could see this from the trailer too, it was like, don't you think Goldar could have had a face?
Yeah, in the show he was more of a, he almost had like a werewolf face,
yeah.
and he talked and stuff.
They didn't want to deal with all those lip sync issues that Goldar had on the show.
Maybe that was the reason why. But
no face.
I like that he was made out of gold though. I mean, that was fitting,
yeah.
and he should be. Since
well,
he's,
they took it very literal that he is like
gold yeah.
and he's...
And also, the putties, something that I liked about them is,
yeah.
I guess they are made out of putty, but they're more like stone.
Mm-hmm.
Stone. I kind of like what they did with that, because, you know, obviously in the original show, they were very, just guys in, like, spandex costumes or something, so they made them a little, I guess, cooler to look at in this,
mm-hmm.
and I really did like the scene with the putties when the Power Rangers first get their outfits, and they're
mm-hmm.
on the top of the mountain, and they're fighting all the putties.
Mm-hmm.
That's very reminiscent to me of the show, where it seemed like every episode of the show, they went out and they filmed like out in the desert, them fighting the putties.
Uh-huh.
It made me feel like I was watching the show.
It did. There were like little moments where I felt like, okay, yeah, this is the current movie version
yeah.
of the show. Like, this is what, you know, you wanted. I mean, I will say, if you're looking for a lot of action, it comes. All the action does come, but it takes a while. Like, I would say it was probably like an hour before they even got into the
It was a while.
Ranger
it was
suits.
Past the middle of the movie.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But like we said, the agenda of this movie was the origin story. It was like kind of, you know.
And I always say with that, it always bothers me with these movies, with these reboot movies, that they just have to retell the origin story again, because it's like we've already heard it.
It depends on the franchise.
When they did it with Batman and when they
mm-hmm.
did it with Turtles, I was just like, come on, get to the next story.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't feel that way with this.
Yeah.
I actually felt like this was something that needed it.
This is what it needed to
I didn't
do,
want
yeah.
to go into this movie and not care about these characters. The worst thing that they could
mm-hmm.
have done was just... had the action start immediately and then be like, all right, well, who are these characters? Why do I care? So they did a lot
mm-hmm.
of that, and they made me care about the characters. So this is a different example where I actually
yeah.
think it was time to do that.
With the effects, some of it looked a little bit like I sort of speculated from the trailers. It did have a little bit of a Transformers kind of feel.
It did.
And of course, I'm meaning the Bayformers stuff. Like,
Megazord.
Megazord looked just like Optimus Prime.
Megazord bothered me a little bit. I wanted him to look more like he did on the TV show. He didn't have to look exactly like
yeah.
that, but a little bit more like the TV show. And he definitely did look something like a Megatron looks in the Michael Bay Transformers movies. And I thought that
oh,
that
more
wasn't...
like Megatron. Yeah, I could see
or
that.
Or Optimus
yeah.
Prime. Or any
it,
of those
sort of, it
characters.
Looks a lot like that. It's becoming a very cliche look nowadays.
It
like
is.
You could see it, like the villain in the Avengers 2, I think,
yeah.
kind of look like that. Like you see it a lot now. And I think it's just...
It's just the style of the times, I guess.
It's a style. It seems like it's kind of like, oh, this is what's successful. Let's play it safe and do this. But it's also like it's hard to come up with something original a lot of times. I think it's just that they're so dry for ideas.
Well, the original show had those amazing, you know.
Oh, yeah. I mean, the original show was like, just like all over the place.
So.
But also the individual Zords, they looked like the Dinobots from the... I think the last Transformers movie.
They did. I will say at least the individual Zords each got their own scenes.
Because in the show, usually they call the Zords and then they make Megazord right away. But this time, the Zords themselves actually kind of fight.
Yeah. And during the Zord scene, before it becomes Megazord, they actually did throw in the theme song momentarily.
Okay, you want me to get started about the theme song?
Yeah, I know you have something to say.
I'm glad it was in there. Here's the thing. I'm really glad that they... finally decide, because all these movies they just don't do, like Transformers, what is it, like they, I mean, what didn't they like alluded to it, or they had it on a radio or something?
Did they?
I forget, that was so long ago now I think about it. Anyway, all these movies seem to throw away the theme song, because theme songs aren't cool nowadays or whatever. And I think theme songs are really important, because it's like with every version of a movie, you can redo a song in so many different ways. You can do it in different kind of instruments, different arrangement, everything. And they finally did it with this one, where we hear the theme song. Although I think they could have done a little bit better, because it's in there briefly. It's in there just where you want it to be, like right when you want to hear
it. It comes at a good moment.
It does come at a good moment. I mean, not the best, but it's in there. It's like during the action. And but it seems as if it was an afterthought, because the mix is very busy. There is dialogue, people screaming, and there's, you know, all this noise going on, and the theme song's kind of in there, where I wanted to hear it more. I was like, oh, this is a new version of the song. I'd like to hear how this one was done, because as far as I know, it's just as good as many of the covers that were done on YouTube, and which there's lots of great ones. Lots of people have covered the Power Rangers theme song and have done an amazing job at it. So I want to hear this being like the big movie version, you know?
And it actually was also in the end credits, too.
Yeah, which we waited deliberately just to like hear if it comes back. Because that was another thing. Right when the end credits start, which is now, it's weird nowadays, the beginning credits are at the end of every movie.
Right,
but
yeah.
You know what I mean now.
That's just what they do now.
That's another one of the things. And I think right then, right when the movie ended and the credits started, then that would have been the perfect time to bring the theme song back. Like, now let's really hear it. And instead, they used that cliche, I Got the Power, or like one of the remixes of that song that's been done since like the early 90s. And, like, you think theme songs are cliche? Let me tell you, that's cliche. Like,
that's true.
That's cheesy.
Right.
You know?
And they do an instrumental version of the theme song a little bit later in the credits.
Yeah.
But I agree. They should have just had the fucking theme song just go right then. Like, it's your opportunity to play it.
It seemed as if they were, like they heard people saying, like, hey, we want the theme song. And then they sort of just slipped it in. Because it's not like the scene in the movie wasn't like edited to like, it wasn't playing to the song. It seemed like the song was just added into the mix of everything.
About theme song and credits, like
oh,
they've been
it
doing...
was orchestral. I just want to say at least the one in the credits.
Yeah, instrumental.
It was instrumental, and it was orchestral, which sounded pretty cool.
Yeah. But about having credits at the end as opposed to the beginning, I will say. You know, when we were growing up, the theme songs and the intros were usually in the beginning, and they've changed that over the years. And does that bother you? Because it actually doesn't bother me. I used to bother me because you wait through all the trailers before the movie, and then the movie starts, and then you have to see all the actors' names, and then finally the movie starts, where now they put it at the end, so it's like you can just watch the movie from the get-go, and then when it's over, if you don't want to see the credits, you can just go. I kind of like it better that way.
You know, it depends. It depends on the movie. I think, why did we do it in the beginning all the time, and now we do it at the end all the time? Like, is there any, like, you know...
Why can't it be both,
the
movie?
Like,
yeah.
Why can't... Because the beginning credits, like, sets the mood. Like,
Marvel movies tend to still have the intros.
I think. Well... Sometimes. Actually, I was going to use an opposite example from a Marvel movie, but actually, let me start with DC or Warner Brothers. here's an example of one that I think worked great with an opening theme is Batman, the 89 Tim Burton one, mm-hmm. because it starts off, it sets the mood for the movie yeah. when it's going through that logo and you're hearing the music. It gets you into the mood. Then with Marvel, we have Iron Man. This was a good example where the credits work great at the end. Because then, like, you know, right at the end, he says, like, I am Iron Man, and dun, dun, yeah. dun, 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 and that goes into the credits. So it can work either way, but why is it always at the end now?
I don't know. What I want to ask you mm-hmm. is, have you seen Power Rangers from Wood Rocket?
No.
It's called Mighty Muffin Power Rangers.
Okay.
Yeah, it's the Power Rangers porn movie that just came out. I was wondering if you saw that.
No,
he hasn't seen that. But you know what else was good about this movie?
Uh-huh.
Kimberly and Trini, they were fucking hot. And one of the other things that I forgot to mention that I loved from the original Power Rangers,
uh-huh.
and I'm not even kidding, I think that one of the reasons a lot of people watch the show is because they like Kimberly
uh-huh.
from the original show, Amy Jo Johnson. Mm-hmm. She was really popular. And the new girls in the movie are really good looking, so that's another reason to go see the movie.
I mean, if you're a young teen, for sure.
Because
they are younger. Kimberly is like, well, she'd be, she's older than us, I think, but.
You mean the actress who played?
The original one.
Amy Jo Johnson.
Jo Johnson, yeah.
So what did you think of Jason as the leader of these Rangers and his role and being sort of getting himself into trouble, as opposed to the Ranger from the original show, you know, was sort of like the weightlifter jock kind of character, where here he's getting himself into trouble. Actually, I guess they all are, because they're all in detention. That seems very opposite of the show, where they're all kind of goody-goodies, you know?
I thought that was kind of perfect. But you see it happen a lot with reboot movies like Star Trek, you know, Chris Pine's Captain Kirk, he gets into a lot of trouble
True.
In the beginning. Yeah.
Yeah.
I see that as kind of like I'm not going to say it's a crutch, but it's kind of a...
It's a trend now.
It's a little bit, but I mean, I'm for it. I think it's a good way to like get... Because you don't want the characters to always be perfect. You like seeing, like, some of the best characters are ones that are flawed, and they have a lot of things to deal
and
with.
And Zordon in this movie, I thought was flawed, and he was the one character that I didn't really want to be flawed. He bothered me a little bit because the Rangers, I didn't mind them being flawed because then they prove themselves and become the Rangers, and that all worked really well. But Zordon, I felt like, really needed to be more of a guiding force. And a lot of times in this movie, he was kind of just like kind of a dick to the Rangers, I felt like. And he did one thing in the movie. I don't want to say what it is. He did one thing that really redeems himself.
Mm-hmm.
But other than that, he was kind of just kind of nasty, I thought. What?
Oh, yeah.
Did you get that sense? A little bit?
He seemed old and tired. I think he's just cranky.
Just old and cranky.
That's all I thought of it. But I was just very much fixated on the look of him. It looked like one of those...
Max Headroom.
No, it looked like one of the... Well, yeah, maybe that.
Oh,
too,
one of those things at Spencer's?
Things you put your hand on? Do you know what I'm talking about?
Yeah, the Spencer's.
Yeah, great description. The thing you put your hand on. I don't know what the hell it's called, but like...
I forget the name of those things.
Yeah, I mean, I had one of those in the 90s, like you know...
Yeah, it looks like that. If you put your face on it, turns
exactly.
to the side.
Well, they you could do that. You could put your face... I think they've even done that in some movies. Yeah.
So you thought that was like this amazing special effect, but really it was just they had a camera close up to one of those
things.
I
thought it looked like they just did one of those. I was like, why does Zordon look like that? You know?
That's funny. What about Alpha 5?
Okay, Alpha 5, I liked the voice. He wasn't annoying this time.
Mm-hmm.
He did say
I, but it wasn't as bad.
Yeah, it was more like a nod to the show. It's like they had to get it in there.
Because kind of like,
it's almost like you have no choice. Like Michelangelo would have to say cowabunga.
Mm-hmm.
You know, Alpha 5 needs to say I, but he didn't do it repeatedly, and he did it. It seemed like he was funny in all the right ways,
mm-hmm.
but he wasn't like just going crazy and like it wasn't like this. And actually, that just reminded me, there was no Bulk and Skull. I never even thought of that.
Well, they had this other bully in the movie, and he was sort of the replacement. If you're gonna have the bully in the movie, why not just have it be Bulk and Skull? I felt like
that's probably the only tribute to the show that they kind of missed. But I don't mind that. Like, it wasn't like, because
It didn't ruin the movie.
There's so much going on. It's like, yeah, it's a little bit too busy to make, like, because Bulk and Skull on the show, they were always like, there were subplots about that. They like here, I feel like they would have kind of gotten in the way if there was like a lot.
If there was more of them.
Yeah. But they could have, yeah, I know what you're saying. Like, they could have just had that, those bullies be Bulk and Skull. It had, you know, just a little nod to the show.
Yeah, I felt like if they're going to have the bully, you might as well make it Bulk and Skull. Like, why not?
Yeah, I mean, I feel like
it was fine though.
Yeah, I don't feel like it was lacking in fan service, you know.
Yeah,
I don't really have any complaints. I mean, I watched it pretty casually. I enjoyed it. Rita was cool. I liked the redesign of Rita.
I thought she was actually really good. They did a good job with
Elizabeth
her. She was scary. There was a scene in there where she actually kicked the Rangers' ass.
And she fights the Rangers.
Yeah,
I mean, there you go.
So with the sequel, I want them to not be afraid to. Keep it a little cheesy. I wouldn't mind if there was actually some monsters in there that they can fight that are ridiculous. There can be like one main badass, like crazy awesome looking monster, but I would love to see a couple goofy monsters in the next one, because that would be the one thing I felt was missing out of this. Like, let's have some goofy. That was the thing
that's
I loved.
Tricky. Yeah, that's tricky to like have, like, you don't want to have like clashing tones of,
you don't know. And it would be hard to pull off probably to get it the right way, but that's the thing I felt that was missing, that it should have, because it's Power Rangers and that's what it was like when we were kids. It was goofy. It was a goofy, cheesy good time, you know. But this movie actually, speaking of a good time, I had a good time seeing this movie. And it had that, it had a good feeling to it, like you leave the theater and you feel good, and you should with a popcorn kind of movie like that.
Yeah.
I think they did a good job with the movie. I would see a sequel.
Yeah, like it's another action superhero movie. It's like nothing special, but it's worth seeing if that's what you want to see. I think it's best for this generation. I think this is the Power Rangers movie to introduce a lot of new, you know, younger people, and I don't really have any complaints about it or anything.
Go Power Rangers.
Yeah, you know, I mean, you know, as much as I wanted to hear more of that song in there, I personally have heard enough of that fucking song lately, because I've been hearing nothing but, because editing all these videos.
Yeah, after all that, you really want more of that song?
Yeah, I do.